10 and 0. Let's see what we've got today. Maybe not. Let's bring the knight up. Let's take. Let's push the pawn up. Shall we attack the knight? Support the bishop. Castle. Take the knight off the board. Any magic anywhere? Oh, he's got loads of pieces there. Let's push this pawn. Let's move the bishop out of the way, preempting. So we can attack the knight. Doesn't have to take. It's coming for an attack on the king, so we take. Still goes with the attack on the king. We move out of the way. Gets a pawn. So he's getting a free pawn in a sense. Let's just push this pawn. Let's take the knight. Need to get this bishop out into the game. Get the queen out into the game. Let's get something happening. Let's get round there, King Gary. Haven't got anything else supporting it, so we potentially could get trapped. We hit the pawn, he just drops down onto the knight. Be ugly. Let's attack the pawn. Attacking our queen. Can sit here, but I don't know. Is it doing much? Go there, bishop attacks him. Maybe we'll just come back here. Alright, so he's attacking our rook. He's attacking the queen. Let's bring it here. So a lot of lockdown maneuvers that they're doing. Maybe we can get something done with that. We do have a flexible knight. They have two bishops in a lockdown situation, so it's not going to be beneficial for them. But how do we get this knight into the game? Okay, maybe we'll go for a little bit of a fianchetto looking situation. Queen, queen. Yeah, obviously it's a bit obvious, but hey, it's a mini plan. Queen's attacking the knight. It's blocking that area off, so it's obviously... If we come here, looking to try and finish that off. He's looking to get the queen in here. And down to here, get the bishop here. Oh, mouse slip, man. I was meant to go here. Take back. Take back, send. That was a mouse slip. Come on, be good. Right, there we go. So we're trying to go for this. They're trying to go for this type thing with theirs. Ours is probably two moves away. So probably good. Oh, okay. Just take. It's keeping the queen there, so we're not going to get that. So we've taken the pawn with the knight, because the queen can take with a check on the king. Just for a bit of dishevelment and maybe getting the rooks involved to try and squish the king a bit more. There's no guarantees of anything working, but you have to try something. So he's not moving his queen from there. He's not taking our knight either. So that could be our saving grace, because we can't get a rook off the board. And they've left the game. So it was nice of them to take the take back. And we'll claim victory on that, because that was pretty nice. We followed through what we said with our plan. So positionally, that felt okay. Very clever. A little bit too clever there. What are you doing? 10 and 0. Oh, same as the last game. Let's go here. Let's take. Let's push. Obviously not identical because the knight came down and stuff like that. Let's attack the queen with a smaller piece. Support the pawn. Or rather defend the pawn. So is there any more work to be done? Okay, they look like they just... So they're going to win the pawn and they'll be on the rook. Must be a fancier way of dealing with this. If we hit the pawn, then if they take, take, whichever way, we've got something to support. I think, yes, that's right. So if he takes here, we take here. Bishop takes, pawn takes, queen takes. Ooh, so they're a pawn up there. Takes. Move order, move order. If we take, bishop takes. Yeah, okay. All right. That's if we take. We don't have to take. But I think we're going to have to take. So the queen's going to be in a nice position. And their pawn up. Oh, let's take. Let's attack the queen. So yeah, they're a pawn up. But positionally, because our pieces are slightly more developed, it doesn't mean much. But oh, he's not gone for the exchange. Nice space here. So we can't castle on the king's side. Smaller piece can attack a higher piece yet again. So let's do that. Pawn attacking the queen. Trying to win some important tempi. He's still wanting to keep us from castling. Let's come here. Knight attacking the queen. Let's attack the queen. It's going to go there because he still wants to stop us from castling. Knight's got this. Or the queen's got that. So it's not gone there, so we can go and castle now. He doesn't like the idea of this, but the knight can still go here with a check on the king. Winning a bit of some sort of tempi because the queen is not going to take. So the king will move. So I'm going to put a check on the king. Support of the queen. This is one of those where delaying castling might benefit you. Alright, so they have moved. We could take the bishop off the board with a check. Rook takes or the queen takes. I don't think there's any other checks. Knight can come here. Knight can go there, but there's no checks on his queen or anything. Only problem we've got is that if we go and castle, then his rook comes here and is on our X-raying through to our queen. So I think we need to move the knight first. I think we need to move it back again, or else we're going to fall foul. Okay, so we've done the big thing. We've disturbed the king. And now they're attacking our queen. Like we said, they were going to be straight for that. X-raying through to their king and also the pawn. May come down and charge here. Do we take the pawn? Queen takes the knight but doesn't see the stealth bishop, and their signal seems to have gone. Oh, interesting. It's nice when you get a bit of luck on your side. Claim victory on that. Thank you.
Thank you.